do believe that health benefits shouldn't be taxed, and what was the middle one?
Employer mandate.
No, because I favor actually personal portability. So I don't favor an employer mandate, which gets us to the question of, well, what do I favor? And that this is one thing that's, quite frankly, at this point, divided the Republican conference. The bulk of us support one of either the Coburn-Ryan bill, the Shattuck bill, or the Price bill, all of which are very similar. And interestingly, contrary to this statement that was made earlier, when I ran in 1994 had an upset victory over the incumbent at that time, healthcare was a huge issue. In fact, Rahm Emanuel had been in charge of the healthcare task force for Hillary Clinton and putting together the meetings, and that's why a lot of the similarities of this bill and options are similar to what we dealt with in 94. I have my campaign handout that included a section on healthcare, and in that, ironically, given the attack that was funded on me in South Bend Television and in Fort Wayne, paid for by Acorn, Planned Parenthood, and the Government Employees Union, asked me because they picked six of us who opposed it in committee and said, we're going to try to intimidate and scare them and show that we can beat them down. They spent $68,000 in 7 days to try to intimidate six of us to silence us for having fought and offered amendments in committee. Now, in that, it said, there was a lady on the screen who said that I didn't favor coverage for pre-existing conditions and therefore she was at risk of cancer. The fact is that when I ran in 94, it says right in my brochure, I favor addressing and solving the pre-existing conditions thing. So how would we do that? And among other things I had is tort reform was first. By the way, there is no compromise, bipartisan, any kind of bill that doesn't have tort reform in it. You can argue that tort reform doesn't impact every category. It clearly impacts birth and delivery questions from particularly young females, but from the doctors even here in Goshen when we were talking, they think it's the number one thing because it doesn't show up clearly. It just shows up as something that they did. You don't know what they would have done had they done a medical risk cost analysis as opposed to a fear of a lawsuit. There's no real way to measure this. But tort reform was one. Portability is another. Association health plans, which is the ability to move across state lines and pool together. A president said that one of his options is like a credit union. You can do that now. We could, in this room, form a company that's tax-free just like a credit union. But we could only do it within the state of Indiana. We couldn't shop for a better price with something with different options other than what the state legislature in Indiana has minimally required. So association health plans would allow a larger pool also for risk pooling and catastrophic. And then I favor tax way of a refundable tax credit for low income and a tax credit for all. Now, it requires in order Senator Coburn, who's a doctor, explains the pre-existing conditions in a convoluted way, but basically you have to have the ability to risk pool, much like reinsurance covers regular insurance, so that insurance companies could say, oh, I have a high-risk case here, catastrophic or this, here's how I buy that secondary policy for that. That's what, in effect, the government's doing by pooling everybody, or an employer mandate, in effect, tries to pool enough people in to so where you get the average, so an AIDS person, somebody who is on their fourth heart, gets averaged with everybody else. Now, you can do it in several ways, but here's our Republican division. As you probably heard, we have a little debt. And everything is expensive when you try to address this. So some Republicans don't want to put all alternative on the table because all alternatives are expensive. But I believe that if we're going to put the least expensive and best health care on the table, it would have to be phased in, dealing with the most critical questions first, catastrophic, and pre-existing conditions, and that you would have to deal with the lowest income first. That this, by the way, would be an alternative, and if it's a realistic cost in how you do it, to even Medicaid, particularly for the working poor just above Medicaid, because that you would, in effect, have the ability to go out and buy in the private market. Because, and this is the end, and what I want to point out is part of the reason that Coburn and Shattuck and these people are introducing bills that are very similar to what I ran on in 94. We all ran in 94. We've been through this before. And people say, well, you guys were in charge. No, we had about 150 conservatives, and then Republicans who sided with the Democrats, and the Democrats blocked our version of health care for 12 years, and then have the gall to say to us, oh, you don't have a plan. They blocked our plan, along with some liberal Republicans.
Right.
We have been trying to pass the same basic free market principles that would have solved the problem when we took over in 95, but we were blocked. Now that at root, and it's a core difference, and this is what the public financing, or what I would call the Fannie Mae version, which is the not-for-profit government entity, comes down to. And that is, and this is what we're going to see this fall, the bill probably gets stripped down, but to make this go, they have to have some sort of an entity, either government itself or a quasi-government like Sallie Mae, Fannie Mae, something like that, competing with the private sector. Because the president said profit's bad. Doctors are cutting off people's feet, insurance companies are ripping people off. The profit is the problem with health care, rather than what I believe, which is profit and competition, would solve the problem if they let profit and competition work without regulation.